Welcome to audio video system playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you OLED television system. OLED means organic light emitting diode television system. And to understand OLED television system, these are my session outline.
So first, I'll discuss basics of OLED. Then after, I'll explain different parameters which is there with OLED. And then I'll explain working of OLED television system. After that, we will see structure of OLED television system. And after that, we will see some advantages and disadvantages which is there with OLED television system. And at the end, I'll discuss some applications which is there with OLED display. So basically, OLED means what? OLED is organic light emitting diode. And OLED display panel, that is what we are using it nowadays in 2019. And Samsung is leading manufacturer of OLED technology. So I'll explain you this session first based on basics of OLED. So let us have this. So see, OLED means organic light emitting diode. So here OLED, that is what solid state device is, and that is creating light based on electricity. So here we don't need extra light source for OLED display panel. OLED itself can generate light based on electrical signal given to it. So its working is almost similar to diode. So in structure, I'll explain you how it is working. And its working principle, that is almost identical to LED diode working. Only a few layers are additionally added in OLED, and those layers are making use of organic radiation of light. So why it is organic? Organic means it is not harmful to eyes, as well as it is environment friendly. So material is environment friendly, it is not harmful to eyes, and energy efficient usage is possible by using OLED technology. So it is made up of series of organic films in between two conductors. So here we'll be having two different conductors. In between that, there will be series of organic films, and those series of organic films is making a similar structure which is there with diode. So there are multiple layers. I'll show you that in structure, so it will be more clear. See, it does not need any backlight to display picture on television, as it can radiate light. So OLED itself radiates light. It does not need any backlight. So it is thin and slim in nature compared to LCD and LED display panel. So it is very efficient. It does not contain any bad material. And that's why it is referred as organic LED. So OLED is what? Organic LED. And why it is organic? The reason is it is very efficient. It does not contain any bad material. And Samsung is leader in OLED display technology. So you'll be finding in Samsung's device, OLED display panel is there, and it is having world-class display. And because of this display quality, Samsung is leading mobile seller in the market nowadays. So one major reason is OLED display. Now let us see first of all different parameters which is there with OLED. See, it is having excellent contrast compared to any other display in 2019. It has excellent black level. So black level light, that is best in OLED compared to any other light till now on 2019. It has no motion blur in OLED. So when you see any motion picture, there is no motion blur which is happening on display. It has very wide viewing angle. So OLED display is having very broad viewing angle. Almost one can say 180 degree viewing angle has been there with OLED. It has excellent color reproduction. So best color reproduction is there with OLED. It is having very good brightness and sharpness. Only LED TV that is having better brightness compared to OLED. But when we talk about sharpness, then OLED sharpness cannot be matched with any panel. So this is what about basic parameters. Now let us see the working principle of OLED. See, OLED working principle is similar to conventional diode, where in conventional LED light emitting diode, there will be cathode and anode. When you give signal to anode with respect to cathode, it will come in forward bias and electrons from cathode will move towards holes of anode and they will get combined and that will be generating light. So this kind of working is there with OLED. So instead of NNP layer, here we use organic layer to generate electrons and holes. In conventional diode, you will be having N layer and P layer, right? But here we have organic layers and that will generate electrons and holes. So a simple OLED that is made up of 6 layers. I'll show you structure so it will be more clear. And here electrons and holes are getting combined and they will be emitting light. So I'll show you structure first so it will be more clear. See, this is cathode and this is anode, this is substrate. So anodes are having holes and cathodes are having electrons. And in between that there are two more layers. This is emissive layer and this is conductive layer. This emissive layer and conductive layer both are organic layer and those layers are made up of polymers, right? Or one can say organic molecules. So see, when we give signal to anode and cathode, electrons of cathode will get combined to holes of anode over here on emissive layer. And as electrons and holes are getting combined, they will be releasing energy as light. And that light is been used in OLED television. So this is how complete structure is working. So here I have shown 4 layers. There could be multiple layers even as it have been mentioned earlier. But simply it is working like this only. There could be multiple layers for some other uses. But simple structure is this for OLED. Now let us have some advantages of OLED. So see, it is thinner and lighter compared to LED, LCD, CRT, plasma. It is thinner and lighter compared to any other television. Contrast is way better compared to LCD and LED. It is having very good black level, right? And you can say best black level is there with OLED compared to any other television system. It is having zero motion blur. It is thinnest compared to any other television. So you will be finding OLED television are slim compared to any other television system. Now see the disadvantages. See, it consumes bit higher power compared to LED display. Not very high power, but 10 to 15% consumption of power is higher in OLED compared to LED display. It has lower brightness compared to LED display. And applications. So see, OLED display that we can use it in laptop screen, we can use that in cell phone screen, we can use this on camera display, we can use OLED on television system, we can use that in portable video games, we can use that in optical imaging.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in their university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topics which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video. And Your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel. Thank you so much.